The latest presidential election, I'm registered as an independent, and I couldn't vote in the primaries, and it kind of seemed like that Hillary kind of won the primaries, and I wanted to vote for Bernie Sanders, but being an independent, I did go talk to Judy Schwenk, when I mentioned her name. She said they were throwing this bail around or something in Harrisburg, but I don't, you know, whatever that means and stuff. And I'm just wondering if they though, you know, if they do anything about that, you know, as far as trying to make it a step of two-party thing, you know, Republican, Democrat, Democrat, Republican. It seems like it's kind of both same thing going on, just, you know, I'll give you this, I'll give you that. We're both in, you know, for this kind of a game. I just, you know, I felt really that in 2017, or, you know, I think that's kind of, I think that's something that needs to be changed. That's one thing. And then the other thing I wanted to talk about, now I'm not really up on it, but I wanted to talk about the LGBT community. You had mentioned something about that. As far as, you know, protection rights in the workforce and in school and stuff. Because I know there's a lot of injustice going around there. A lot of people can't even speak about who they are, or right away they get accused of being too, standing too close to somebody, they'll be accused of sexual harassment, being written up, and all kind of, you know, it's like a witch hunt, you know, and it just makes me think back, you know, the predecessors, like for women and stuff like that, you know, where they were today, those women in the early days, what they had to go through so that these women today can be where they're at. It's the same thing with the gay community, the lesbian, transgender community and stuff. No, well, yeah, healthcare, always healthcare. Hey, you know, to be become like you know, one board assistant and stuff, I stand by that 100%. So I don't know, you can give me some feedback on that. There was something else, maybe I'll think about that too, come to that.
You start to feel like a pot of plant back there, sitting there by myself. Very quickly, though, your question was about the hostility toward Brennan from others. I took it like what I've experienced in my career as a politician, part-time politician, is that there always is, and there is a hostility between the rural folks, and they look at the cities and they look down at the cities. Now, the solution from my perspective, like education, etc., is it's a generational situation. You have to raise better kids. You got to change them. Kids learn a lot of this stuff in the families. I mean, as a school director, you have problems in schools, and you wonder where are these kids learning this stuff? Because there's, you know, there's bigotry, bullying, and things that go on in schools. They're learning it from their families. So there's a lot of work. It's going to take a long time. And as far as the two-party system is here to stay, it's not going away. When I was younger, I had those thoughts, man, this is crazy. It's not going to change. When I was mayor, I registered a bunch of folks. They chose to be independent. One guy, my neighbor in back, Fred. Fred comes up to me knocking on my door on primary day. Bill, you registered me to vote. They won't let me vote. And I said, Fred, we get a form. You got to re-register Democrat. You can't vote in a primary. So it's a choice, it's a personal choice. Some folks, that's very important, that independent spirit. Lehigh County, independent registration going up. I don't know how this works. Independence going up, there's more and more independence. People are making that personal choice because it's a bellwether of people's negative feelings toward both parties. You had said that they're kind of like pretty similar. From my view, they are different. There's elements within the Democratic Party that are too close. I mean, if it changes, so be it, but I don't want to have you leave head down. That's not going to change. I thought about this again and again. What we could get rid of is the Electoral College. What we could get rid of is this crazy voting on a Tuesday. It goes back to when people were farmers. I don't think how many farmers in the room? Maybe not many. Former farmers. But anyway, so, and then the health care, I mean, I'm Medicare for all. Obamacare is basically a Republican plan. Can think tanks, and we couldn't get the public option in Obamacare, which really hurt the effort. So we got basically a Republican plan that we have our arms around tight, which we have to loosen up and work towards single payer. It's going to take a lot of work, though. It's one step at a time. But we can do something else. I forgot what the other LGBT community. Listen, I've been a member of the American Civil Liberties Union, card carrying since 1978. In 1981, Ronald Reagan came to town. As a young man, when I heard a Klansman from Louisiana or Mississippi say, you know, his platform could be written by a Klansman. That is frightening. I heard about the Southern Poverty Law Center. They had, at that time in 1981, they had a program called Klan Watch. I thought this was great. They put all these suspected Klansmen and Klansmen in the computer, keep an eye on them. I thought, this is great. I joined. I've been a member with the Southern Poverty Law Center since 1981. I would urge everyone to consider joining both those organizations, if anybody is members at this point in time. Thank you, because both are getting, the Southern Poverty Law Center, right, has been drug in the mud, calling it like a left-wing terrorist organization. It's nonsense. It's unbelievable. You want to say messaging, but you call it like it is. They're lies, and they know they're lying. That's the part that's terrible. Thank you.
I think the essence of the question is about folks who feel disenfranchised. And I think there are many reasons why people feel disenfranchised. I think there are legislative fixes, and I think there are personal fixes. On the legislative side of things, we have to look at voter rights. We have to look at, you know, RFIDs. We have to look at gerrymandering. We have to look at Citizens United and the amount of money that's going to influence in campaigns.
Which I only found out 2 years ago. So I was great. I know I'm 40, right? grade, and I found out when I was 38 that my parents, their political parties. But I was raised in a house where you should choose the best candidate. And so I empathize with what you're talking about. But then I ran into the reality that Bill was talking about, which is that we have a two-party system. And you're absolutely right. Keep on Judy Schwank about this question, because unfortunately, it's not a federal issue. It's a state issue. And Pennsylvania is behind in a number of areas. And there are a number of people in this room who have lived in other states and who can attest to that. You know, we don't have a voting period, we only have a voting day, and we have all sorts of things that make Pennsylvania very special. And so that's one of the things, but I think it's an important point, and it means that some people have voice in the primary and some people don't, and that's unfortunate. In terms of the LGBT community, it's something that we'll continue to fight for in our campaign. Both Lancaster and Reading, and this is sort of where we can bring folks together, is issues like this, because these two cities have such incredibly strong LGBT communities, and really our, you know, my job as a candidate for Congress is to represent the voices of my district. And those voices are very strong and much stronger than people sometimes believe. And in our area, which is often perceived as being quite conservative, it's actually quite moderate on this issue. And so folks are very supportive, generally speaking. I would say more than 50% of folks in Pennsylvania 16 are very supportive of these issues. So we will be out and proud, both as Democrats and as supporters of the LGBT community.